Hi everyone. Today in this video, let us talk about letrozole. How this drug acts, what are the clinical uses, side effects and precautions of letrozole. Letrozole is one of the drugs which can be used to treat the postmenopausal breast cancer. So it is one of anticancer agent used to treat the breast cancer in the postmenopausal woman, particularly the breast cancer which is hormone responsive. And what are the breast cancer which is in the advanced and metastatic stage? In these two conditions, letrozole can be used to treat the breast cancer in postmenopausal women. And this drug can also be used as an adjunct to tamoxifen. Tamoxifen is one of the drug which can be used to treat both premenopausal as well as postmenopausal breast cancer. So when this tamoxifen is given in the postmenopausal breast cancer, letrozole can be added as an adjunct to increase the efficacy of the treatment. In all these situations, we can easily see that letrozole is used in the postmenopausal woman and this drug is not effective in the premenopausal woman. And letrozole can also be used as an off-label purpose for treatment of infertility because this drug can increase the ovulation. So, letrozole can be used to treat the infertility in anovulatory women. So, women who are having less ovulation, in those letrozole can be given to increase the ovulation. Actually, in the anovulatory women, one of the drug clomiphene can be used, but this clomiphene can also act as an estrogen antagonist, resulting few of the anti-estrogenic side effects. In such case, letrozole can be used to treat the infertility. So today in this video, let us see how this letrozole is only useful in the postmenopausal breast cancer and how it is effective in the treatment of infertility. First of all, let us see the structure of letrozole. Letrozole is having the structure like this and you can see it is not having any steroidal nucleus. So letrozole is a non-steroidal drug and this drug belongs to one of the category aromatase inhibitors. Among the aromatase inhibitors, we have one of the drug eximistane, which is a steroidal aromatase inhibitor, but letrozole is a non-steroidal aromatase inhibitor, therefore it lacks the steroidal side effect that can be produced by eximistane. And this letrozole is having one of the heterocyclic ring system with 3 nitrogens and 5 membered, so this is nothing but the triazole. So letrozole is a triazole containing aromatase inhibitor. Now let us see how this letrozole acts in the postmenopausal woman as well as to treat the infertility in the anovulatory woman. In the postmenopausal woman, estrogen is not synthesized within the ovaries, but the estrogens can be produced by extra-adrenal synthesis. So within the ovarian follicles as well as peripheral tissues and within the brain, estrogen can be derived from the androgens. One of the important intermediate in the androgen pathway is the androstenedione. This androstenedione can be converted into estrone. Otherwise, testosterone can be directly converted into estradiol. These two reactions are mediated by one of the enzyme, aromatase enzyme. Because estrogens are having an aromatic ring, so in order to bring the aromaticity to the first ring, androgens should be modified such that new double bonds are going to be produced, resulting in the aromaticity. So this reaction is mediated by one of the enzyme, aromatase enzyme. So this is the androstenedione. You can see that here it is having only one double bond at the fourth position and a ketone group at the third position. Now this first ring should be converted into an aromatic ring. So now this androstenedione can be converted into estrone, and here you can see that the ketone is converted into enol and an extra double bond is also introduced such that the first ring becomes aromatic in nature. Now this reaction is mediated by aromatase enzyme. Letrozole can block this aromatase enzyme, thereby it can inhibit the conversion of androstenedione into the estrone. Similarly, testosterone can also be converted into estradiol. Again, you can see in the testosterone, a ketone group is present at the third position and double bond is present at the fourth position. So now this testosterone is converted into estradiol, again in a similar way, where the ketone is converted into enol and a new double bond is going to be introduced by the same enzyme, aromatase enzyme. So again here letrozole can block this aromatase enzyme, thereby it can inhibit the conversion of testosterone to the estradiol. In this way, within the peripheral tissues and ovarian follicles, the estrogen synthesis can be blocked by letrozole by inhibition of aromatase enzyme. In this way, letrozole can inhibit the estrogen production in the peripheral tissues. Therefore, it can reduce the estrogenic activity in the breast tissue, resulting in the inhibitory effect on breast cancer. That's why letrozole is used in the treatment of postmenopausal breast cancer. And since it is not directly blocking the estrogen receptors, it is not suitable for the premenopausal breast cancer where estrogens are synthesized within the ovaries. So, letrozole is only used for the postmenopausal breast cancer. But how this drug is used to treat the infertility in the anovulatory women? So, this is the hypothalamus. This hypothalamus is going to send the signals to the pituitary, and this pituitary can then send the signals to the adrenal cortex. So, this is the HPA axis. Now, this HPA axis can be controlled by the levels of the hormones within the body. Now, androstenedione is one of the important precursor for production of estrone in the postmenopausal women. This androstenedione can be converted into estrone by one of the enzyme, aromatase enzyme. Now, letrozole can inhibit this aromatase enzyme. Thereby, it can inhibit the synthesis of estrone. Now, when the estrone is not synthesized, the decreased levels of estrogens can send the negative feedback to the hypothalamus as well as to the pituitary, such that hypothalamus is going to release one of the important mediator, gonadotropin-releasing hormone. This gonadotropin-releasing hormone is released and it can act on the anterior pituitary, such that it is going to release another mediator, follicle-stimulating hormone. This follicle-stimulating hormone is going to be released such that it can increase the follicular growth. As the follicular growth is increased, it can increase the ovulation. In this way, letrozole can increase the follicular growth and ovulation in the anovulatory woman. What are the precautions? One of the important precautions of letrozole is the decrease in the bone mineral density. The bone mineral density is reduced by aromatase inhibitors like the letrozole, which may result in the increased fractures in the patients as well as increased risk of the osteoporosis. And particularly osteoporosis is more observed with the anti-estrogens. So, the risk of osteoporosis can be further increased by tamoxifen when the tamoxifen is combined with the letrozole. Similarly, another important precaution is the increased cholesterol levels. Letrozole can produce the hypercholesterolemia, which may sometimes require the therapy with the statins to reduce the cholesterol levels. This hypercholesterolemia can increase the risk of atherosclerosis and other cardiovascular disorders in the patients who are having the baseline levels of the cholesterol within the body. And again here, the tamoxifen can increase the hypercholesterolemia. So, whenever tamoxifen is given along with the letrozole, there is an increased risk of hypercholesterolemia. And third important precaution is that letrozole can increase the hepatic impairment. So, if patient is already having any hepatic impairment or liver cirrhosis, in such situations, letrozole can further increase the hepatic impairment. In those patients, the dose should be adjusted such that letrozole will not produce any toxicity. So, these are the three important precautions that should be taken before the letrozole is given to the patients. What are the side effects? This drug can produce few of the side effects like hot flashes and arthralgia, headache, fatigue, asthenia, weakness can be observed, and other symptoms like dizziness, edema can also be observed in the patients. This drug can also increase the excessive sweating, and finally, it can also lead to the hypercholesterolemia and hepatic impairment. All these are the important side effects that can be observed with the letrozole. How it is given? Letrozole is given as a tablet form and it is given at a dose of 2.5 mg once daily. But in case of patients who are having the hepatic impairment like the liver cirrhosis, this drug is given not daily. It is given at alternative days in order to reduce the toxicity. So that's about the letrozole. Letrozole is an aromatase inhibitor which is non-steroidal nature, which is not having any steroidal side effects. This drug is going to inhibit the extra-adrenal synthesis of the estrogens from the androstenedione as well as testosterone. Androstenedione is converted to estrone and testosterone is converted to estradiol. Both of these reactions are mediated by aromatase enzyme, which is going to be blocked by letrozole. That's why letrozole can be used in the treatment of breast cancer in the postmenopausal women. And this drug can also increase the follicle stimulating hormone levels by negative feedback mechanism. As the estrogens are not synthesized, it results in the negative feedback to the hypothalamus and pituitary, which release the more follicle stimulating hormone, resulting in the follicular growth and ovulation. Letrozole can be used as an off-label purpose to increase the ovulation in the anovulatory women. This drug may increase the risk of fractures because it decreases the bone mineral density, and it can also increase the cholesterol levels, which should be thoroughly monitored. And it can produce few of the side effects like the hot flashes, arthralgia, headache, dizziness, and it can also produce some hepatic impairment where the dose should be adjusted, and letrozole can be given on alternative days in order to reduce its toxicity. So that's about the letrozole. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel, share this video with your friends, post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.